You can't receive unless you trust. Your trust messed up. If only we can receive what God says about us. Y'all not getting this yet. That's why many of you walking defeated tonight. That's why some of you got low self-esteem, but you hide behind your fig leaves because you really can't receive what God says about you. God says that you the head and not the tail. God says that you are the lender and not the borrower. I wish I had a receiving church tonight. God says you are above and not beneath. Do I got a receiving church tonight? God says that you are more. I wish I had somebody in here that would receive the word. That's the problem. You don't have a child's receptivity because you're still blocked up with your past. So when something is said, your prophet speaks to you. You get blocked up with the garbage and you can't receive it. And you cannot enter into the kingdom without having receptivity. How do I get receptivity? You got to learn how to listen. You got to hear. Faith comes by hearing. And hearing the word of the Lord. You must have receptivity. They, children, they believe what you tell them. Some of you so skeptical about church and about preachers and about people that you walk around, you skeptical and you inspecting and you walking around, can't trust. Preacher wants your money. Y'all not saying that, but I'm talking. So right now you come in here with all kinds of walls. And while God trying to give you something, Lord have mercy, you can't receive it because you're skeptical. But I came here to break that wall, kingdom-minded people, that you can get what God has for you. Listen, sit right up off of here right now with a giant wall. Ain't hearing nothing I got to say. But if you don't hear nothing else I got to say, if you don't receive the kingdom like a child, you're going to hell. If you don't get that, I'll see you later. Because when the rapture comes, you won't have me to preach anymore. Because I'm going to lay down and take my rest. All right. So, it's amazing how open they are. Children are open. I remember the other night that sometimes I try to teach my wife stuff. And my wife, bad mama jam, but she's stubborn. And that's a good trait though. Because once she got saved, can't nothing change her. Right? But sometimes we're not open. I can get a child information quicker than I can get an adult. Because we so closed-minded.
Yes, yes. Talk about it.
Can't get through to you.
That's right. That's the truth.
This is how I always did it. That's why you're at the same place. Tell somebody, open your mind. Open your mind. Tell them. Open your mind. They're open-minded. Well, you know, people, we tell people, you know, who's supposed to be kingdom-minded to tithe. I don't know why I'm still staying there because many of you are not receptive about your tithe. See? And that's keeping you from really being over-blessed. See? God's still keeping you because we're in grace, but you just running a rat race. And you just cannot for the life of you give a dime out of dollar because you can't receive. If I told a child, right, I gave him a dollar, and I say, baby, you're supposed to give God 10 cents, they won't have a problem. Unless some of you self-centered, spoiled people have taught them to keep that stuff. See, because what you teach a child, they be receptive to. Now, if you got to them before I got to them, they probably hold back their dime. But if you teach them early to give a dime, they ain't gonna have no problem off the break. Come on, they receptive. I'm trying to preach you into the kingdom. I'm not trying to preach you right now, even into heaven. I'm trying to preach you in the kingdom of God right here on earth. Glory to God. I'm not trying to teach you church. Teaching you kingdom. Now, you know, because we don't have kingdom, everything easily gets on our nerve. Because we're churchy and not kingdom. See? Church stuff get on our nerve. And I'm trying to grow that I can just shut my mind off of church stuff. Because I'm supposed to be kingdom minded. Because I believe God. Can you say amen? Amen? If I don't watch it, I let Negroes pull me right back into a church mindset. And then I'll be asking the question, God, will you make a way out of no way? When you're kingdom minded, I shouldn't worry about a bill because I trust God. I shouldn't worry about nothing because I depend on God. And if in fact I'm doing what I got to do because I'm receptive, God will do what he has to do. Can I get 10 people to say amen? I'm preaching, but y'all looking at me tonight. So a child is receptive. And if a child lives, watch this, with much criticism, he learns to condemn. If a child, this for you, lives with hostility, he learns to fight. And if a child lives with fear, he learns to be apprehensive. If a child lives with pity, he learns to feel sorry for himself. Receptivity. If a child lives with jealousy, he learns to feel guilty. Are y'all here? If a child lives with encouragement, he learns to be self-confident. If a child lives with tolerance, he learns to be patient. Y'all not getting this. If a child lives with praise, he learns to be appreciative. Quiet church right there. Y'all know I love praise. I appreciate what God has done for me. If a child, watch this, lives with acceptance, he learns to love. And if a child lives with approval, he learns to like himself. And if a child lives with recognition, he learns to have a goal. Y'all quiet. If a child lives with fairness, he learns what justice is. And if a child lives with honesty, he learns what truth is. And if a child lives with sincerity, he learns to have faith in himself and those that are around him. And if a child lives with love, he learns just who God is. Y'all not getting this here. What he learns, he becomes receptive to it, and he begins to react on what he's learned. And the problem is, we can't learn because we're closed-minded. We want to do it our way. And can I help y'all right now? And so many of us now, we have let the world come into church. You're not called to be sexy. You're called to be holy. And then we begin to blame the young generation. It ain't their fault. It's the generation before them. Because what a generation tolerate, the next generation embrace. Now we come any kind of way in church. I'm just tired of being loose now. Just accepting it. Come as you are and do all that. There should be a standard in God. I'm tired of trying to fit the world to win somebody. You either gonna live right and live holy or go to hell. I'm tired of it. Holiness must come back. Who has told you you can get away with it? I ought to preach that y'all get mad tonight. Ought to know how to guide your eyes. out there. Well, God gave me eyes. You ought to thank God he gave you eyes. But you ought to thank more God gave you eyelids to close those big eyes. Just won't accept it. He called us to be holy and holy still. We accept anything and say, baby, it's going to be all right. A watered down gospel. We ought to preach righteousness and living right and living holy. Baby, it's going to be all right. No, it ain't going to be all right. You're going to hell. Quiet church now. Preach old till they get mad. Preach till they get mad. I got to preach holiness and righteousness. No, it ain't going to be all right. No, you ain't going to keep on sucking on dope and doing that and coming back. God will kill you. I'm tired of playing pity patty and pacifying you and chasing you. Get right or get left. There's going to be a standard. We're going to live holy. You are called to be holy. If you're going to be Baptist, be holy. If you're going to be Methodist, be holy. Called to be holy people. Separated. Sanctified. Coming here with these nasty dispositions and attitudes like God owe you something. Holiness, which without no man sees. Come. I ain't tolerating it no more. Living any kind of way. Coming into the house of God. Wearing anything in the house of God. Show your butt. Show everything. Get right.
That's right. That's right.
Come as you are. No. Come right. Just right. Be holy. I'm tired of being young and trying to get the swagger with the people and be all right. No, honey. Now, listen, I can't. No, God, thank you, Holy Ghost. I repent. Bump the compromise. You got to live holy. Getting high. Coming back. Going to think. Acting like a fool. You better get holy. Can't run around with all the women in the church. I ain't preaching to y'all. I'm just preaching. I ain't preaching to y'all. I'm just preaching. I hope they hear it on Facebook. You can't run around with the women in the church being horned around. Those are daughters in Zion. Get yourself right. Lord, have mercy where I get this from. Gotta be holy. Baby, it's going to be all right. No, it ain't going to be all right. Chance after chance after chance. Live right. Why we ain't preaching perfection no more? Water down gospel. It's going to be okay. Just come to church because you want the church to be full. Good God Almighty. You ought to leave here mad at me. It ought to quicken your body. It ought to make you say, I got to get right. Now, baby, okay, you coming back to church now. You're going to be all right. Just keep sinning. God grace you, and God loves you. God also is a God of judgment. Y'all ain't hearing me tonight. Y'all not hearing me tonight. Want a soft, petty message. Make you feel better. Encourage you. No, preach the whole gospel. The whole gospel. Not no prosperity message. I want I want to make you prosper. Right? We shout over that. But we forget, even as your soul.
That's right.
Prosper.
Come on now.
How you going to be in sin and your soul prospering? Expect God to bless you. Second, I'm preaching against sin. Man, I ain't got time to play around. running around with everybody in line to die. Then come in here and say, God, I'm going to repent. What if God takes you? Preach old till they get mad. Come back for the third point next week. I'm done. Come on, come back for the third point next week. Dependence and trust. Four point. What did I do? Receptivity. Sorry. I done went somewhere. I wonder.